New technology is exciting, but the purchase and inventory procedures might not be as much fun. With InvGate Insight, you can build the process and automation that your teams dream of. Let me show you how. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. IT procurement and inventory are the foundation of the asset lifecycle, and they can have a considerable impact in how the rest of your ITAM strategy develops. If you get to capture some crucial details as soon as goods enter your organization, their management becomes much easier, and you can even automate parts of it. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along, and you'll find a link in the description below. There can be as many procurement paths as there are assets in your company, so let's go through some of the most common situations. There are basically two categories of asset purchases: assets and technology that require a fast delivery time, like workstations, software licenses, and peripherals. These types of assets will require you to keep some quantity in stock for use in the future. And then there are assets that don't need a fast turnaround and can be ordered as they're needed. No stock is kept on hand. So for items that are kept in stock for immediate deployment, the traditional procurement method involves monitoring the stock levels and understanding your volume. Looking at our stock levels on our asset dashboard, I can scroll down here to my custom dashboard where I've got my assets in stock, and I can tell that we need to order monitors. We've really only got one left in stock, and it's in Buenos Aires. If your team is like my team, everything starts with a ticket, so we'll put in a request in Service Desk to request more of these items be ordered. So I'll create the request. I'll be sure to request monitors, and we'll do a quantity of 10, and we'll send that along. Now, what happens after that is up to your needs, of course, but our workflow is set up to request an approval from the desktop support manager, and then procurement gets a task to order the monitors. At this point, my team waits for the monitors to show up, and when they arrive, they're inspected and counted, and of course, to make sure we receive the right equipment in the right condition. Now, we don't just order monitors, we order laptops and other things as well, so those things need to be received as well. Once the items are inspected and received, we take them to our workbench and we image laptops, or we put things directly into inventory. Laptops are imaged and then added to inventory, where other equipment is just added directly to the inventory. Now, in my example, we're ordering monitors, which would simply get entered into InvGate Insight. In fact, our vendor sends us all the details about our equipment in a spreadsheet so that I can quickly upload these into Insight and get these monitors into stock. I can go to Import, where I can download a template Excel file. I'm just going to rearrange the columns real quick on my asset worksheet, and now we can upload the assets themselves. For more complex technology like servers and laptops, they'll get imaged first, then they'll have the InvGate agent installed, which pushes their information to InvGate Insight. And when I say information, I mean we literally have everything we need to manage this computer. For example, here's a laptop with the agent installed. And we're getting information about the hardware, the applications installed, all the way down to the model number, and in some cases, we can even capture the warranty information. If anything's missing, the agent can correct it here. For instance, I always make sure the warranty date is correct, and our SOP, or standard operating procedure, also requires that I upload a receiving checklist onto the asset record. Now, one final step before putting them in stock is that I download and apply a QR code to each of the machines. These can be created directly in InvGate Insight. I can go to the machine itself and generate a single QR code, or I can go to a list of assets, say maybe just show me all my notebook computers. I can select which assets I want to print tags for, and simply download the QR codes for those selected assets. And once received and put into stock, our procurement team really just cares about managing the asset from a financial perspective. So we have a simple two-way integration with our ERP system using our open API. This way, they keep track of the assets as financial investments, and we keep track of them as computers and IT investments. Our IT risk and compliance team uses InvGate Insight, so if we have something that gets stolen, we have lots of up-to-date information about the contents of that digital asset. So the asset now gets placed into inventory. The next time that we see that asset, it will be called up for service. And this is just one aspect of InvGate Insight that's designed to make full cycle asset management easier. For more on this topic, subscribe to our YouTube channel or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.